Hello viewers, today we are joined by Admiral Arun Prakash. He has been India's Navy Chief and Chief of Staff also. And today it's our honor that he is with us. We'll have a short discussion with him, and I hope you all enjoy it. Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, my first question to you would be that looking at the capacity of India's neighbors, especially or particularly China, having developed the capability to develop state-of-the-art war machines and war platforms, including aircraft carriers and nuclear submarines, do we need to worry, or is our Navy capable enough to counter the threat?
Well, first of all, let me say that as far as the Navy is concerned, China is not a neighbor. As far as the army is concerned, they are neighbors because of a common border. But as far as the Navy is concerned, China is an outside power. Whereas the Navy is, we are a resident power. India is a resident power in the Indian Ocean. The Indian Navy is operating in home waters. So if China wants to come into the Indian Ocean, they have to travel 4,000 to 5,000 miles away from their home base. So we are at a definite advantage. The second point is that the Indian Navy is a very modern force. Most of our ships and submarines are being built at home. So it's our units are new, our equipment is modern, our training standards are pretty high. So as far as the Indian Ocean is concerned, as far as India's maritime interests are concerned, the Indian Navy should be, is well able to take care of Indian interests as far as Chinese Navy is concerned.
Sir, recently we have seen reports in which it is said that China is setting up a base in Jiwani in southwestern Pakistan, which is particularly the state of Balochistan, and they have built a low frequency station there. So do we need to worry, because in the deep seas it is said that low frequency stations are pretty much tough to track or trace. So does India need to worry about the having a Chinese naval base with such a state-of-the-art status in our neighborhood?
Well, if it's a low-frequency stations are meant to communicate with submarines. So if your information is correct, and I have not heard this, if your information is correct that in Jiwani they're establishing a low-frequency station, then it means there is a possibility that their submarines might be based there, or maybe operating out of place like that. So certainly it is a matter of concern, because Pakistan is next door. But the other aspect of this whole issue is that Jiwani, Gwadar, etc. are all within striking range of our aircraft and our ships. So anything that is based there also becomes a good target for us, although it is a threat certainly, because it is at the entrance of the Persian Gulf, a lot of trade goes in and out. But should things go seriously wrong, then it is also a very rich target for us within range of our units.
So the next question would be, looking at the recent agreement between India and France, that India and France can share each other's ports, be it in Djibouti, be it in Abu Dhabi, or in the Indian Ocean region. How do you read this development?
Well, it just shows that France is the interests of France in this area are convergent with the interests of India. That is why France has gone out of its way to put forward this agreement, and it's a very useful agreement because it is mutually beneficial. Our ships, our aircraft can use French bases, and the French are also very far away from home. They can make use of our bases. So it's a very mutually beneficial and mutually reassuring agreement, especially in the context of what the Chinese Navy is planning to do.
So the final question to you is, looking at the pace of development, how the Indian Navy has been working really hard since your tenure also, we have seen that Indian Navy has increased its capacity to develop indigenous platforms enormously. I don't think any other service has developed such a capacity in such a short period of time. So do you think that India needs more platforms and more investments? Are we spending enough, or we need to increase our spending on the defense manufacturing and procurement?
Well, certainly if you ask any armed forces person, he will say yes, we need more money. But the fact is that at this moment the money, whatever the country can afford, there are many other requirements. I think that is all right, just enough. The problem is to how to spend that money efficiently in order to modernize the armed forces. That process is very, very deficient and defective. We are unable to spend the money. We are unable to buy things that we need. So I think the system in the Ministry of Defense needs a great deal of reform so that the money that is allotted, we can spend it. Otherwise, every year we are surrendering funds back to the government, because the system in place for acquiring hardware, for acquiring weapon systems, etc., is very defective.
Thank you so much, sir, for joining us.